students, now it is time to discuss IIT paper. Okay, morning you have completed IIT paper and you got marks also. So now we will discuss each and every questions, whatever the questions were there for IIT test. Okay, so see here the question book 1, the chemical formula of zinc hydroxide. See, I have given already notes to you. Just open that all notes before to start the discussion, then you will get the idea. See, in that all the formulas are given. Okay, so here the name, that is a zinc hydroxide. Okay, and what is the chemical formula of zinc hydroxide? Then how to make the formula? See, zinc hydroxide, what is the symbol of zinc? Zn. Okay, and hydroxide means OH minus. To form a chemical formula, we should know the valency of each and every element. Okay, so what is the valency of zinc? 2. So I written here 2 and hydroxide 1. Okay, then we use here the crisscross method. So while writing the chemical formula, ZnOH twice. Okay, because this 2 number will be given to OH. Why? Because this crisscross method. Okay, so what is the chemical formula of zinc oxide? ZnOH twice. This is the correct answer. See in your question paper, option number 1, ZnOH twice. This is the correct answer. Okay, now see the next question, question number 27. The empirical formula is, and dash it is given. Okay, see the empirical formula is, the option was given, the first one is the simplest formula, second one is molecular formula, third one is chemical formula, and fourth one is an ionic expansion formula. Okay, so the empirical formula is the simplest formula. What is the correct answer? Simplest formula. See this definition, it is given in your notes. Okay, just open that point, empirical formula. This first only sentence was given. This empirical formula is the simplest formula because it is the short form of a molecular formula. Okay, now next question, see question number 28. Okay, in this question what they ask, see in NaCl, NaCl means what? Sodium chloride. Okay, in NaCl the valency of Na is, means now here they ask about the valency. What is the valency of Na? See, so to calculate, to find out the valency, we should know the atomic number. Okay, so what is the atomic number of sodium? 11. And see this electronic configuration, how to find out the valency, we learned before only. So 2, 8 and 1. So in the outermost shape, how many electrons are present? 1 electrons. Okay, and in the second shape, 8 electrons. So what? 2 stable. Na means 2 stable. This one electron, it will be lost. Means they will donate to someone this one electron and sodium atom will become stable. So the valency of sodium is plus 1. Okay, understand it. Otherwise, you draw this way and you just distribute the electrons. Okay, in the first shape, how many electrons? 2 electrons. Second, 8. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and first shell 1 electron. So total, how many electrons? 11 electrons. So in the outermost shell 1 electron, so it will be donate and sodium will become stable. So what is the valency of sodium? Valency of sodium is plus 1. Why plus charge? Because it donate 1 electron, and for that here plus charge is, okay, positive charge. Now next question number 29, see the valency of carbon is, again the same question, means how valency of sodium, same way the valency of carbon. So what is atomic number of carbon? Atomic number of carbon is 6. Okay, then again they distribute electrons in the shell. So first shell 2 electrons. many electrons are present? 4 electrons. So 4 electrons carbon can donate also, and carbon can take to a base table. Okay, so what will be the valency? Valency will be 4. Okay, donate or accept anything means according to the situation, carbon can take 4 electrons and carbon can donate 4 electrons. So next question number 30, the valence, question number next 30, the valency of magnesium is the same way. What is the atomic number of magnesium? Okay, just write down the question. Question number 30, the valency of magnesium is, and the correct answer is 2. The same way you have to do it. Okay, now the next question we will see, that is question number 31. Okay, now we will discuss question number 31. See, what is the question number 31? An atom of sodium has an atomic number 11. First, read question properly. See, what is in the question? It is given, an atom of sodium has an atomic number 11 and a mass number 23. See, atomic number 11 and mass number 23. Which of the following statement is correct? Okay, means in this question, what they given? Atomic number and mass number, and related to that some sentence is given downside in the form of option, and you have to find out which one is a correct option. So I written here correct option, that is an atom, option number C is correct. An atom of sodium has 11 protons, 11 electrons and 12 neutrons. Okay, this option is correct. Now why this option is correct? See, what is the atomic number is equal to number of protons and number of electrons. This everyone you know that. Okay, atomic number means only number of protons and number of electrons. So number of protons and electrons is equal to 11. How 11? Because atomic number of sodium is 11. So number of protons and number of electrons also 11. Okay. Now next, see what is the formula, how to calculate the mass number. Mass number is equal to number of proton plus number of neutrons. Okay, and in this question the information is given, that is mass number is 23, is equal to number of protons 11 and number of neutrons we don't know. Okay, so to find the number of neutrons, what the number of neutrons is equal to mass number minus number of protons. So 23 minus 11, so what will be the answer? 12. So here we get how many number of neutrons are present in that. Okay, so number of protons is equal to 11, number of electrons also 11 and number of neutrons 12. So which option is correct? Option number C. An atom of sodium has 11 protons, 11 electrons and 12 neutrons. Okay, write this in your notebook. These all explanation and solution also I given. You write this in your notebook. Okay, now next question we will discuss, that is question number 32. Okay, now we will discuss the question number 32. Okay, what is the question number 32? An atom of phosphorus has an atomic number 15 and mass number 31. How many neutrons does it contain? See, in the last question the same we found neutrons only, and in this question also we have to find neutrons. Okay, so what is given in this question? Atomic number of phosphorus. Okay, the symbol of phosphorus is P. So what is the atomic number of phosphorus? 15 and mass number 31. And what we have to calculate, find out neutrons. Okay, so atomic number
is equal to number of protons and number of electrons. So whatever will be the atomic number, same number of electrons and number of protons. So therefore, number of protons is 15 and number of electrons also 15. Why? Because phosphorus atomic number is 15. So number of electrons also 15 and number of protons also 15. Okay. Now, see here. So how to calculate neutrons? Mass number minus number of protons. So what will be the, what is the mass number? See, mass number given 31. Okay. And minus number of protons. So 31 minus 15. So what will be the answer? 16. So how many neutrons does it contain? 16 neutrons. See, what is the question? How many neutrons does it contain? So 16 will be the correct answer. Okay, 16 is correct answer. So option number B in your question, option number B, 16 is correct answer. Now see the next question, 33. Okay, what is the question number 33? See, valency is the number of electrons of an atom which an atom can. Okay, then how the valency is determined? What is exactly valency? Okay, options are given. First one is donate. Second one is accept. Third one is donate or accept. And last one is none of this. Okay, so what will be the correct answer here? How the valency be determined? Maybe it means it is donate also and accept also. So the option number 3 is correct. Okay, valency is the number of electrons of an atom which an atom can donate or accept. Okay, this is the correct definition. Now the next question, that is question number 34. The ions having positive charges are, see, in cations and anions we learn, okay, and in that notes also it is a given. So the ions having positive charges are known as a cations, okay, and negative charge means what? Anions. So the ions having positive charges are known as a cations. Because why? Because they donate electrons to become stable and the form a ion. For example, I will give you one example. Suppose this is a sodium. Okay. If you will write only Na means what? It is a sodium atom. Okay. Then where it lost one electron. Okay. Why? Because to stable, sodium has to lose one electron and it become Na plus. So this is known as a sodium ion. Okay, and this is known as sodium atom. Okay, one electron it lost, so it becomes Na plus. Na plus means what? Sodium ion. So the ions having positive charge are known as a cations. Okay, now see the question number 35. Next question, that metals usually form what? Mostly all the metals are usually formed anions, cations, no ions and neutral. See, mostly all the metals usually form cations. Okay, mostly all the metals donate electron, means they lost electron. For example, see, sodium is metal. Okay, potassium is metal. Magnesium is metal. So these are the examples of metals. So mostly all metals usually form cations. Why? See here, the plus charge means mostly all the metals are donate electrons to become stable. Okay. Now the next question, that is question number 36. See, what is the question number 36? What anion is this? See, question number 36. This you write down in your notebook, everything. Okay.
See question number 36. What anion is this? And in bracket it is given OH minus. Okay.
So see here, OH means what? It is a very simple question. OH means what? Hydroxide. Okay. OH means hydroxide. So what will be the answer? Hydroxide. Last option, option D is correct. OH hydroxide. Okay. Now next question we will continue. That is question number 37. Okay. Now next question we will continue. That is question number 37. Okay. What is the question number 37? What is the empirical formula for the following molecular formula? And that formula it is given, that is C6H14. Now the name of this formula is hexane. Okay, it is the series of hydrocarbons that will be learned afterwards, but you should know the name of this formula. So what is the name of this formula? Is a hexane. Okay, what you don't have to think about the name now, just you have to write the empirical formula. Okay, what is the empirical formula for the following molecular formula? Means some in the options it is given. So which one is a correct for this this formula? Okay, so see here, C6H14. First, what is the empirical formula? See, empirical formula means what? It is the simplest formula and it shows the whole number ratio of an atom. Okay, empirical formula, it shows the whole number ratio of an atom. See, while discussion, just open your general chemistry notes, in that all the information it is given. Okay, so see, 2 3s are 6 and 2 7s are 14. So it is the simplest ratio of this formula. Okay, C6H14. So this one is a correct answer. How? See, we just have to 2 3s are 6 and 2 7s are 14. So the correct option is, see which one it is given, the correct option 2. See, 4 options are given, that is first one is C6H14, second option is C3H7, third option is CH2, fourth option is CH3. So which one is the correct option? Option number 2, that is C3H7. Okay. Now the question number 38. See, what is the question number 38? The formula which gives the simplest whole number ratio of atom is. Okay. So it is a definition only, whose it is and the which formula is given the simplest whole number ratio. There are many formulas, that is a molecular chemical formula, so you, in the options, but you have to choose the correct option. See, what is given? The simplest whole number ratio. So which formula is given the simplest whole number ratio? That is the empirical formula. Okay, so option number 1 is correct. See, first option empirical formula, second option molecular formula, third option chemical formula, and fourth option is actual formula. So which one is given the simplest whole number ratio of atom? The correct option is empirical formula. Okay, now we will continue next question, that is question number 39. What is the question number 39? See, again the same, you have to form a formula. Okay, the molecular formula of potassium nitrate. See in your notes, that box it is given, in that all it is given and how to form a formulas, that already we learned before. Okay, so potassium, this is a potassium and nitrate. So potassium symbol K plus, now that you know. Okay, NO3. So the valence we will exchange it. So what is the correct formula? KNO3. Potassium also 1 and NO3 minus. So here no number is given, means what it is? 1 only. Okay.
So KNO3, what we are not mentions most of the time. So what KNO3 is a correct option. So option number 1, KNO3 is correct option. Okay, now question number 39, we will continue. Okay, write these all questions and answers in your notebook. Now, so now we will continue question number 40. Okay, what is the question number 40? See, what is the formula mass? See here, the name is different. That molecular weight, how to calculate the molecular weight, molecular mass, okay, the same, molecular weight, formula mass, molecular mass, same. So what is the formula mass of unit ZnO? ZnO means what? Zinc oxide. Okay, so to calculate molecular mass, we should know the atomic mass number, okay, atomic mass number of zinc and oxygen. So what is the atomic mass of oxygen? See, 16. And atomic mass of zinc? 65.38. So we will consider 65. Okay. So ZnO. How to calculate the formula mass? ZnO. What is the atomic mass? 65 plus oxygen. Because now here we have to find out the whole this formula mass. So, Zn mass plus oxygen mass, then we will get the actual mass of ZnO. Okay, understand it? Formula mass means what? All this formula mass we have to find out. So, we should know the zinc mass and oxygen mass. So, oxygen mass is 16 and zinc mass is 65.38. So, total formula mass of this formula is 65. Plus 16 is equal to 81 mu. Okay, this is the unit of that. So you will get the answer. This is 81. Okay, so option number, your options are given. First option 80, second option 81, third option 88, and fourth option 188. So which one is the correct? 81 is a correct option. Okay. Write down this in your notebook. Now, related to this question only, the another question only, the name is different given. See, relative molecular mass. Here formula mass and here it is given relative molecular mass of CO2. Now, we have to find out the mass of this whole compound CO2. Okay. So, for that, we should know the what is the atomic mass of carbon and atomic mass of oxygen. When addition of these both the masses, we will get the molecular mass of this compound. Okay. So, see here, atomic mass of carbon is equal to 12. What is atomic mass of carbon? 12. And atomic mass of oxygen? 16. Okay. So, carbon 12 plus oxygen 16. But now here, see, how many atoms of oxygen? 2 atoms of oxygen. So here we have to multiply with 2. Why? Because oxygen atoms, how many are there? 2 oxygen atoms. So 16 into 2. So 12 plus 32, you will get the answer 44. So which option will be correct? Option number B. See, relative molecular mass of CO2 is option A 22, option B 44, option C 66 and option D 88. So which one is a correct option? Option number B 44 is a correct option. See, from last year I was telling you to by heart the atomic mass also, and if you don't know the atomic mass, with the help of the number of neutrons and protons also, you can calculate the atomic mass number. Okay, so do practice of that. It's very important in 10th standard also. So many questions are related to this. It is given. Okay, so understand this, how this answer come. Okay, now the next question we will continue, that is the question number 42. Question number 42. See, question number 42, the oxides of iron can presented as. See, in a lesson, metals and non-metals, this reaction we have seen already. Okay, how to form the oxides of iron when metals react with water. That already we learned that. Okay, so just you have to write the formula of oxides of iron. So what will be the formula of oxides of iron? Fe2O3. So this option is correct. So what options are given in your paper? See, the question option one is FeO2. This is wrong. Second one is Fe3O5. That is also wrong. Third one is Fe2O and fourth one is Fe2O3. So the correct option is option number 4, that is Fe2O3, because already we discussed before in the lesson. So now we will continue. The next point, the next question, that is question number 43. See, the atomicity of K2Cr2O7. See, atomicity means what? How many the atoms are present in that particular element? That is only known as a atomicity. But here what they ask the atomicity of this whole formula. Okay, this whole formula, that is K2Cr2O7. They not ask the separate atomicity. See, if they will ask only the K potassium, then what is the atomicity? How many atoms are present? 2. So atomicity is a 2 for this. Okay. Then for chromium 2 and for oxygen 7. But they ask the atomicity of this whole formula. So we have to just add. We have to do addition. 7 plus 2, 9, and 9 plus 2, 11. So what will be the atomicity? 11. Okay. So option A was given 9, B 11, C 10 and D 12. So which one is the correct? 11, because 7 plus 2 9 and 2 plus 2 means 9 plus 2 11. So atomicity of this whole compound is 11. Understood? Okay. Now we will continue. Next, that is question number 44. See, molecular mass of water. See, molecular mass, formula mass, okay, relative mass, the same. Water. See, this H2O, this formula, it is not given. So at least you should know how to write the water. What is the formula of water? H2O. Okay, so for that, we should know atomic mass of hydrogen. What is the atomic mass of hydrogen? 1. See, atomic mass of hydrogen, 1. And atomic mass of oxygen, 16. Okay, just have to do the addition. So H2O, so 1 into 2. Why now 2? Because how many atoms of hydrogen? 2 atoms of hydrogen. So 1 into 2 plus oxygen, only 1 atom, so only 16. Okay, 2 ones are 2 plus 16. So you will get the answer, that is 18 mu. Okay, so 18 will be the correct answer. So see here, option number D. Option D is correct, that is 18. Okay, now the next question we will continue. That is question number 45. Okay, 45, what is the formula for tetraphosphorus trisulfide? See here, this is very important. Tetraphosphorus trisulfide. See, you know that phosphorus and sulfide. But to find the correct formula, this tetra word is important. See, tetraphosphorus trisulfide. Now tetra. See, diatomic, triatomic, tetra. Di means 2, tri means 3, and tetra means 4. So here they ask, tetraphosphorus means P4 and trisulfide means S3. So P4S3 is the correct option. It's very simple. You just read carefully the questions. Okay. So tetraphosphorus P4 and trisulfide is S3. So tetraphosphorus trisulfide, correct option is P4S3. See, options was given. Option number A, PS3, already wrong. B, P4, okay, P4 here it was there, tetra, but trisulfate it was not given, okay, only S was given, so this is also wrong. Option number C, P3, S4, now here triphosphorus tetrasulfide it is given, okay, so this is also wrong. And option D, P4, S3, this one is the correct option, that is P4, S3, tetraphosphorus trisulfide, okay, understand it, okay. Now the next question, that is question number 46, one molecule of sulfur contains, see this one is a very simple, every time you are writing S8 means what? 8 atoms of sulfur, so it is a one molecule of sulfur, so the options are given, 2 atoms of sulfur, wrong, 8 atoms of sulfur, this is the correct option. Then 4 atoms of sulfur and 1 atom of sulfur. So this, which one is the correct option? Option number B, that is 8 atoms of sulfur, S8 is a 1 molecule of sulfur. This one is a correct option. Okay. The next question, that is question number 47. It's very common. See, in which of the following industries does chemistry play an important role? Okay. See, I will repeat again question. In which of the following industries does chemistry play an important role? Option A, agriculture. Option B, paper. Option C, transportation. And option D, all of the above. See, chemistry play important role in all these three options. In agriculture also the fertilizers and all, in that the chemicals and it is used, so chemistry is important for that. Manufacturing of paper also chemistry, chemicals, importance. Transportation, the fuels and all, it is also the part of the chemistry only. So these all the three options are correct. So the correct answer is all of the above. Option D is the correct. Okay, now the question number 48 we will continue.
Okay, now we will continue the next question, that is question number 48. Okay, what is given in question number 48? Just you have to form a molecular formula of sodium sulfide, NaS. So the cross arrangement, then Na. Valency 1, then N2, so Na2S. Okay, so this is the correct formula of sodium sulfide. Now next question number 49, that is the substance which has the formula mass of 133.5 mu is. Now see, now here they not asked to calculate the formula mass. Already in the question it is given the formula mass, now you have to find out formula mass, okay. So for that just all options are given. The first option is MgCl2, you find this what is the formula mass of MgCl2. Second one is S2Cl2, third one is BCl3 and fourth one is AlCl3. So the correct option is option number D, AlCl3. How? See here, Al, aluminium atomic mass is 26.98, chlorine atomic mass is 35.45, and chlorine, how many atoms are there?
3. So this 35.45 into 3, because 3 atoms of chlorine. Then you just have to do the addition. See here, our figure 27. 27 you can take here, then directly 27 plus this multiplication 106.35, and the answer is 133.35.
So the correct option is, which is the correct option? Option D is the correct. See here it is given 133.5 and our answer is 133.35. So here little bit point difference is okay. So the correct option is AlCl3. Okay. Now next question number last, that is question number 50.
You have to calculate the formula mass of NaCl, the same procedure, atomic mass of sodium plus atomic mass of chlorine, and you will get the correct answer. That is, atomic mass of sodium is 23 and atomic mass of chlorine is 35.45, and the addition you will get the answer, that is 58.45. So the correct option is option number 2 is correct option. Okay, so we discussed today all questions, all 25 questions. See, you know how many marks you got in this paper, but all the questions I written on the board, so that all questions you write down in your chemistry notebook, as well as the solution answers of all the questions. Okay, so now we will stop. So next we will meet in the next period. Thank you.